I want to say good morning to everybody. I want to welcome each and every one of you to OBC this morning, and I want to ask you to open your hearts and your mind to come in and let's live up the name of the Lord this morning. I want you to look to your neighbor and let each and every one of your neighbors know that it's already done, it's already taken care of. Whatever it is, we just want to ask you, Lord, to fix it. So I want to take a moment to say a quick prayer with you guys, and we're going to go ahead and press on in the name of the Lord. But will you bow your heads for a word of prayer? Dear Heavenly Father, we want to thank you, Lord, for this day that you have blessed and made for us, Lord. I want to thank you, Lord, for waking us up in our right mind. And thank you, Lord, that we had life in our limbs and we have food on the table to eat this morning. Thank you, Lord, that we had clothes to put on our backs. And just thank you, Lord, for the sun that you provided for a little daylight, Lord Jesus. We want to thank you, Lord, for just keeping us as we slumbered and slept all night, Lord. And I want to ask you, Lord, to go before us in the hospitals and bless the sick and shed in. They need you the most, Lord, because a lot of people didn't make it today. I want to ask you, Lord, to be with the family that the people didn't make it today, Lord. Just bless them in a mighty way. You know what they need. And, Lord, these families all over the world, we're pressing and we need you right now, Lord. And we ask you to do all things that you said you would do in the name of Jesus. And Lord Jesus, at the end of the day, we want to ask you to keep us close to you as possible so that we can strive to be more like you every single day and help us to just keep on pressing on in the name of the Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Today we'll be coming out of Job chapter 10, verses 1 through 9. My soul is weary of my life. I will give free course to my complaint. I will speak in the bitterness of my soul. I will say unto God, do not condemn me. Show me wherefore thou contest with me. It is good unto thee, and thou shouldest oppress, that thou shouldest despise the work of thy hands and shine upon the counsel of the wicked. Hast thou eyes of flesh, or seest thou as man seeth? Are thy days as the days of man, or thy years as man's days, that thou inquirest after mine iniquity and searchest after my sin? Although thou knowest that I am not wicked, and there is none that can deliver out of thy hand. Thy hands have framed me and fashioned me together round about. Yea, thou dost destroy me. Remember, I beseech thee that thou hast fashioned me as clay, and wilt thou bring me unto dust again. That's our scripture for today. Amen.
All right, come on, bless God this morning. Come on, be thankful for seeing another Sunday. Come on, put those hands together. We come to praise and worship God, and we thank God for his mighty grace and his mercy, and we just want to thank. Just want to pray forever and ever for all you've done for me. Blessings and glory and honor. Thank for blessing me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Come on, hear me say that.
Just wanna praise you forever.
For all you've done, I'm gonna know that God has been good to you. Come on, blessing
and honor,
they are. Thank you, Jesus, for. Come on, let's say that again. I just
wanna praise you
forever and ever and ever and ever for all that you've done for me, blessings and glory and honor, God. They all belong to you.
Thank you, Jesus.
For blessing
me.
Oh, I
just wanna praise you.
Come on, y'all. Y'all know this.
Forever.
It's real simple. It's real simple. If you know it, stand up on your feet and tell God, I wanna thank you forever for all you've done. Because he didn't have to do it for me. Come on. Blessings and glory.
And glory.
And honor.
And honor.
They all
belong to you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
For blessing.
For blessing me.
Oh. For all you've done for little old me, for me. How many are thankful for blessings and glory? How many are thankful for grace and mercy? They
all.
Come on, thank you. Break it down. I want to do it like this. I want y'all to be my choir this morning, if y'all don't mind. I just real simple, easy song. Ain't too many words to it, ain't too many parts. I want y'all to participate. Because see, y'all need to participate in praise and worship also. All right. So let's hold off, choir. All right, here we go. Back to the top right here. Come on. One, two. I just want to. There we go. Come on. Come on, sing to God. Don't sing to me. Tell God, because see, we need to be ministered to sometimes. Sing to us. Yeah. Let us know how good God has been to you. Yeah. Come on. Blessings and glory. Okay, now, can we do it as one big choir? Come on, everybody, no music. Just one. Come on, let's send it up to God.
Forever.
That's it.
And ever.
That's it, come on.
And ever.
Come on, tell God for all that
you've done.
For little old me.
For me.
Because God knows I didn't deserve it. Blessings and glory.
And honor.
They all belong. Come on.
To you.
Blessings and glory. Come on. And honor.
They all belong.
Come on again. Blessings and glory.
Blessings and glory.
Come on. If you really mean that this morning.
And honor.
If you really know that this morning.
They all
that everything belongs. Come on. That's my favorite part. Keep singing that.
They all belong to you.
35 and young, you might not appreciate this one. But see, I thank God for my mama taking me to church when I was a little kid. And I learned how to call on the name of Jesus. And not only that, I learned how precious the name of Jesus was. And it reminds me of April 27th. Knows what happens to that neighborhood. And I can remember being around my classmates watching the storm form. And as it got closer and drew near, we ran into the apartment, and it was about 10 to 15 of us in the bathroom. And we went and got a mattress and put it over our heads. And I thought about what I heard Shirley Caesar say and what I heard Rance Allen say. There's just something about the name Jesus. And y'all, I begin to call on Jesus out loud. And see, I knew that everybody I was around, they really didn't know Jesus like I know Jesus. But I am convinced to this day that because I called on the name of Jesus, that tornado hopped over where I was. So you can't tell me, can't nobody tell me, because I know for myself. And I love the call on his name.
To call your name,
Lord,
oh Jesus.
Jesus,
oh sweet Jesus,
Jesus.
Every day.
Your name is the same.
When my troubles surround me and I didn't have to despair, Lord, you told me that you'd be right there. Seemed like all my problems has just begun, but I didn't have to worry no more, cause they were already won.
Jesus.
Jesus. call your name.
Calling your name.
When I'm all alone in the midnight hour.
Jesus.
And ain't got nobody to turn to.
Jesus.
I know I can depend on you to
every
be there.
Day,
yes, I can.
Your name is the same.
Oh, oh Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh, sweet Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh, how I love,
how I love
to call your name,
calling your name, Jesus,
Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus.
Oh, how I love,
how I love
to call.
There's something about the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you, choir, for leading us in worship. The Bible says that the name of Jesus, every knee gonna bow, every tongue gonna confess that he is Lord. I don't know about you, but that's the sweetest name I know. Is more powerful than President Obama. More powerful than the governor or the legislator. At the name of Jesus, demons flee. Oh, man, I love to call Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you. Thank you so very much. Listen, we're so happy to see each and every one of you here today, and we thank God for your presence and your participation, and we thank God that you have come to give God praise on this first Sunday in August. Amen. And we thank God for all of you. And if you're a first-time guest here today, we want you to know that you are very special to us. And so if you're here for the first time, you can just slip your hand up. If you're here for the first-time guest, okay, we have none. All right. At this time, we will stand and greet one another and say good afternoon. At this time, and the choir will give us some music as we do that. Come on, let us stand and greet our neighbor at this time. Thank you so very much. Speak to my heart, Holy Spirit. Give me the word that will bring you new life. Words on the wings of the morning, the dark nights will fade away. Speak to my heart. We need the words, we need the words. Speak to my heart, Holy Spirit, give me the words that will bring new life. Lift wings of the dark nights will fade away. Speak to my heart. Speak to my heart. Give me your heart if I can.
heart.
Hey, Lordy,
give me
your Holy One.
If I can't hear from you,
then I know what to do.
Never go on my own.
Just let your Spirit guide
and let your Word
of God
speak to my heart.
Speak to my heart, Lord.
Give me your Holy Word.
And if I can't hear from you,
then I know what to do.
Never go on my own.
Just let your Spirit guide.
Yeah.
Speak to my heart.
God bless you. God bless you. Just a few announcements. Listen, our Sunday school is 11. Matter of fact, if you're a leader, stand up. If you're a leader, stand up. If you're a leader, stand up. If you call yourself a leader, you want to be a leader. If you're a leader, stand up. Stand up. Stand up. Stand up. Okay, that's all we got. We ain't got no leaders in the choir. We ain't got no leaders on the ushers. If you head a ministry, if you head a ministry, if you're on the executive board, all right, you need to be standing, all right? I need to see, and if you work in ministry, I want you to stand also. If you work in ministry, stand. Y'all keep playing, man. It ain't gonna be all right. Listen, I need to see you just for a few minutes downstairs in the music suite after the worship experience, all right? So just for about 10 minutes, I need to see you, all right? You can be seated. Also, listen, all these people that just stood up, you need to be in Sunday school. Hello, somebody. Yes, Lord. Yeah, everybody that just stood up, you need to be in Sunday school. You know, amen. You need to be in Sunday school. All right. Children's Church will resume in September, and so we'll tell you more about that later. Also, this week we'll start back our Wednesday night service, Wednesday night prayer, and youth fellowship, and 6:30 Bible study will be Wednesday night. Of course, we have live stream for our Bible study and our Sunday worship. Also, if you need information about our church, you can go to our website, obctuscaloosa.org. Giving is available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Also, our radio broadcast is every Sunday, 5 p.m. on 107.3 FM, 104.3 FM, and 1280 AM. Also, our daily prayer conference call is at 6:30 AM, 7 days a week. All right, our quarter drive was a success, and so we want to thank you that donated to our children, but the funds will be put in our youth budget, all right? We found out that there are some regulations prohibiting us to give financially to Clara Verna. And so we didn't know that. And so we kind of jumped the gun on that, but that's all right. The money will go to good use. I want to thank you all for $444.09. Amen. Thank you for that. Our teens, high schoolers, only won by $10.35. All right. They had $123.60, and our kids, the third through sixth graders, were $10.35 behind them, so we are excited about that. All right, also, there will be a meet and greet. We're starting a new curriculum starting Wednesday, and so we got new teachers, and we want you to come out and meet them, and we have something special for you Tuesday from 6:30 to 7:30, parents and guardians. We want you to do that. Also, our back-to-school bash, I understand, Dave, it was a great success. Amen. I want to thank all of the willing workers. We had 44 youth from the ages of 4 to 18. We had 16 willing workers. We had 3 parent volunteers. And this is what the youth told me. The pitcher man, which is David, and that's what they call him, and Willie Daniels, all right? We also had some awesome speakers, 2 awesome speakers, crafts, talent show, movie, PlayStation tournament, and a scripture scavenger hunt, which was by Taylor Sullivan, Kiara Parker, Alexis Polk, and Trey Grant. Their time was 1 hour and 45 minutes. And to my understanding, my baby boy holds the belt for staying up all night. Amen. That's from what I understand. At 4:30, he was still up. At 5:30, he gave up the ghost about 5:45. He couldn't take it no more. So he is now the Southeastern Region President of the Neighborhood Watch. He's over Alabama, Georgia, and Florida. And his assistant is Paisley Cran. Amen, amen, because she stay up late too. Amen. So God bless each and every one of you. Thank you so much for all that you do. And at this time, we want to prepare our hearts and our minds to give unto the Lord that which he has given unto us. And we're going to ask that the officers and the ushers come to receive our tithe and our offering at this time. To receive our tithe and our offering at this time. Listen, I do want to say it. Do want to say to you that it's very important. Very important for us to be intentional about our giving. Intentional about our giving, okay? All right, listen, we can't be God-given no matter how hard we try. And so I want to try to get this over to you as much as I can, but I can't make you do anything, all right? All right, God has to move on your heart, but I need to tell you, it's not a gimmick, it's not a scheme. I'm not gonna do a $100 dime, I'm not gonna do a $200 dime. I don't believe in that. I believe you put it out there, folk are mature enough to do what they need to do. But here's the thing that we all must understand. Our commitment is to God, all right? Our commitment is to God, and before you do anything, you ought to take care of God's business. All right? Because what happens is when you release your tithe and when you release your offering, you are saying to God that I trust you with the 90% that I'm left with, that you're going to take care of me, that you're going to make ways out of no ways, that you're going to stretch out. This ain't enough money. I know your check ain't enough. We live from paycheck to paycheck. But what you're saying is that you trust God to stretch out what you need to be stretched. Now, here's the thing. Now, you ain't got to give God his money, because what happens is, if you don't give it to God, you'll have holes in your pocket. Okay, I'm going somewhere. In other words, watch this. If you give to God and you need two tires on your car, and God is saying, listen, she trusted me, he trusted me, I'm going to let him ride on the Maypops a little while longer. Because they trusted me. And so here's the thing. We trust God with everything else. We trust him with our health. We trust him with our children. We trust him for our relationships. But do we trust him with our money? Here is the thing. The Bible says, will a man rob God? Yes, he will. Some of you rob God every week. You put him at gunpoint because you will not trust him with what he has blessed you with. In other words, watch this. I pray every day, and I ask God, listen, I want to be a giver. I want to be able to give $500 a week. Do you know what my salary would be if I give $500 a week? Good God Almighty. But guess what? The reason that some of you can't get your next blessing is because you ain't being a good steward over what God done blessed you with. Y'all ain't got to say amen. That's all right, and keep getting quiet. I'm going to keep on talking about money. Y'all better say amen. Amen. All right? Because here's the thing. We're not in this building because we saved. These lights ain't on. This air and all this kind of stuff is not here just because we saved and we filled with the Holy Ghost. All right? I hear people say this, and please, ma'am, please, sir, do not ever say this, because you're going to be cursed with a curse. Don't ever say you can't afford to tithe. Some people say, I can't afford to tithe. Well, that's just like telling Alabama Power, I can't afford to pay y'all. I have got to a point in my life that I'm scared not to tithe. Okay. What I'm trying to help you is, listen, without faith, it's impossible to please God. What I'm saying is, you can't just talk faith and not put your faith in action. And let me tell some of y'all, thank y'all time, but you ain't doing nothing but giving an offering. Because guess what? We supposed to tithe out of every income that we receive. I knew we were going to get crying right there. I know you got that extra job to buy your children some Nikes and some Jordans for school. But listen, even out of that, God says you need to give me a dime out of every dollar. One dime.
I want to tell you that, listen, we got to increase our faith. We got to trust God. We got to trust God with our giving, because giving is a part of worship. We can't come in here and shout and fall out and speak in tongue and then ain't giving God nothing. I can preach right here. If y'all want, I can just preach about, you want me to go to Malachi? Y'all know what to say. So here's the thing. At what point are you going to get it into your mind, into your heart, that the reason that you have money problems is because you ain't honoring God? Okay. Because people that tithe don't have to come to the church to get their bill paid. But people that do everything else, turn up, buy a new outfit, get you some new weed, get your nails done, get your hair done before you give God, then you give God the change. Okay. Y'all ain't ready. What am I saying? I'm saying it's time for us to put our faith in action. It's time for us to not be only hearers of the word, but we got to be doers of the word. It's crucial. It's important. It's important to God breathing on your finances and blessing you. Let me tell you how much the government don't even trust us. They take the taxes out off the top. Because, see, we African American. You know, we'll say, well, you know, I ain't got it this week. We'll pay them next week. No. FICA said, no, I got to get mine off the top. Social Security said, I got to get mine off the top. They don't even trust that we're going to pay. But God trusts you that you're going to give according to how he has blessed you. And so I'm asking today that you take this faith walk with me. I no longer tithe what I make. I've been past that point. I tithe what I want to make. I'm serious. I tithe what I want to make, what I want to bring home. That's what I give God. Because guess what? What I'm doing, I'm putting my faith in action. I'm saying, God, okay, you can trust me with this little bit of money, and so let me go and increase it so you can trust me with more. Because watch this. The more he gives to me, the more I'm able to bless him. Watch this. And not only does God bless my finances, but watch this. Because I sow into the kingdom of God and I give him what he so rightly deserves, watch this. He keeps some stuff from me. Some sickness will pass by me because I'm obedient to his word through my giving. Okay. All right. Y'all got it? All right. Deacon is going to come pray. Y'all don't see how y'all looking. Deacon is going to come pray. And today is the first Sunday. Brother Myers and Deacon Grant, get a tray, get an extra basket. And so today is our first Sunday. You know, it's our fellowship feast Sunday, And so we want to do that. $1 is all we ask that you give. Thank you so much. You've been so diligent and you've been so patient with that. And so we thank God for each and every one of you. Deacon Pruitt is going to lead us in prayer as we get ready to give.
Father God, we just come to thank you. Thank you for this moment. Thank you for this opportunity, Father, to give, Father. Heavenly Father, I pray that we will take these words in our heart and be obedient to your word. Be good stewards of what you have given us and give back to you the 10% that you ask. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Thank you, Brother Deacon. The choir will give us some music. We want you to stand on my left and my right as we come to give our tithe and our offering. The usher will direct us around as we come to give unto the Lord that which he has given unto us. So at this time, let us stand on my left and my right. The usher will direct us around. Thank you.
away. The economy's down, people can't get enough pay. But as for me, all I can say is thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Folk without homes, living out in the streets, the drug habits, some say, they just can't beat. Muggers and robbers, no place seems to be safe. But you've been my protection every step of the way. And I wanna say thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Hey, hey, hey. It could have been me.
As we continue our series of summer,
from the book of Job, chapter 10. Job chapter 10.
Whoa, oh Lord, oh Lord, you've been good to me. I was just standing here thinking, looking back over my life, and you so been good to me. When I was down and out, I didn't have a dime. You made a way for me so many times. Hey, and you brought me from a mighty long way. You've been a mother for me. You've been a father for me. You've been a sister, a brother too. Oh, you didn't leave me. You stayed right by my side. And when trouble came, you wiped the tears from my eyes. I could have been dead, sleeping in my grave, but you made all death behave, and you brought me, hey, from a mighty long way.
Oh, us from a mighty, mighty Lord. I'm young, but I like. This morning, you got to think about how God has made way for your ways. He has given you the activity of your limbs. I don't know what else God got to do for folk. Because there's a whole lot of folk that don't have what you have. And they're not able to put on their own clothes. They got to wait on somebody. Breath in our body that's able to give God praise, we'll sit there like we at a party or a concert. And, you waiting on the sermon, and God said, I'm waiting on you to praise.
Yes, sir.
And so I want to admonish you to please, ma'am, sir, don't wait till you get here to try to feel the Spirit. Because I don't have to come here to feel him. I feel him in my car. Feel him on my job. It's just, my God. Let me say this, I'm preach. I was, young lady at my job was going through something. She just asked me to pray for her. I was trying to check out the line, give me some sweet tea. I really didn't want to bother, but I had been praying with her father passed away. And so, pray with her. We pray. And man, right in the middle of the cafeteria, she just started speaking in tongues and just went in. I said, my God. Because you know, some folk can't speak in tongues unless they're in a pulpit or they got folk around them. I'm talking about went all the way in and the folk was about to call the folk. I said, ain't nothing wrong with her. Just let her be. She'll be all right in a minute. It's an amazing thing to feel the presence of God. Wherever you are. Amen. Listen, I want to continue for about 15 minutes. I know we have communion. I do want to give you this word as we continue our series on Why Me. So many people are going through so many different things, so many different trials, so many different tribulations, and you are wondering, where is God in this situation? It seems like the more you do right, the more hell you catch. The more you make up your mind that you're gonna do it God's way and not the world way, it seems that all hell just shows up at your house. But I want to let you know that you are on the right road, you're on the right track. Because what the devil wants to do, he wants you to come back to him. He don't want you on the side of the Lord. He wants you to continue doing what you were doing because you didn't have no problems. But let's be honest. When we were in sin, we ain't had no peace. You ain't have no peace in what you were doing. I mean, you know, you got to watch your back. That ain't no life for nobody to have to worry about. Is somebody going to shoot you or kill you, or somebody's wife going to jump on you, or somebody's husband going to shoot you because of what you're doing. That ain't no good life. I mean, you ought to be able to walk anywhere in town and have peace. But I found out, watch this, that the reason that some people can't have peace with other folk because they don't have peace with themselves. I'm preaching better than y'all responding. And so watch this. What the Bible says, the peace of God. Watch this. Some people have peace, but they don't have the peace of God. Because see, when you got the peace of God, no matter what folks say about you, you still can go to sleep at night. When you got the peace of God. And then not only do you have the peace of God, when you have the peace of God, then it moves you to peace with God. In other words, you understand that what they say about you, you don't have to answer because you have the peace of God and you have peace with God. And so what God will do, if you shut your mouth, he'll fight for you. But the problem is we try to work stuff out ourselves, and God is saying you got to understand to have the ministry of silence. Sometimes you got to close your mouth and let people talk, because I found out that if you let people talk long enough, they'll slip up and they'll tell on themselves. And so I know that you're going through this afternoon. I know your children are acting a fool. I know bills are due. I know you don't have enough money. All kind of stuff is going on in your life. But I got an announcement to make to you today, that if you just stay with God, that after a while, I don't know when now, but I do know that the Bible says weeping may endure for a night. But if I can just get to the morning, if I can just get to the morning, joy will come. And so let's look at Brother Job, because in chapter 10, Brother Job had some issues with God, and he went off on God. He really did, because Job said, now listen now. In verse 3, he said, does it please you to oppress me, to spurn the work of your hands while you smile on the schemes of the wicked? Job said, now wait. I'm in this because of you, and I'm going through this because of you, and you're not coming to my rescue. Have you ever been in such a storm in your life that you felt that God had forgotten you? It seems like everybody else is moving up the ladder on your job, but you are the one doing the training. Matter of fact, you have some bosses like I had that you had to train the boss to know the job. But watch this. You stay right there and you kept treating folk how you wanted to be treated. And I keep telling you that you don't have to brown nose to get what God has for you. All you got to do is stay with God, and somebody is looking at what you're doing other than God. And so here's Joe. Joe said, now all this stuff is happening to me, and you sitting back and you ain't saying nothing. Then he says, verse 4, he says, do you have eyes of flesh? Do you see as a mortal sees? Are your days like those of a mortal, your years like those of a man, that you must search out my faults and probe after my sin, though you know that I am not guilty and that no one can rescue me from your hand? Your hand shaped me and they made me. Will you now turn and destroy me? Remember that you molded me like clay. Will you now turn me to dust again? Do you not pour me out like milk and girdle me like cheese? Clothe me with skin and flesh and knit me together with bones. You gave me life and you showed me kindness in your bones. But it is what you concealed in your heart. And I know that this was in your mind. Watch this. I like verse 14, because he says, if I sinned, you would be watching me and you will not let my offense go unpunished. He said, if I'm guilty, I'm sorry. Woe to me. Even if I'm innocent, I cannot lift my head, for I am full of shame and drowned in my affliction. Verse 16 says, and if I hold my head high, you stalk me like a lion.
and again display your awesome power against me. Verse 17, you bring new witnesses against me and increase your anger toward me. Your forces come against me, wave upon wave. What is going on? Some of us are just like Job this afternoon. We have mistaken views on our suffering. See, you think what you're going through is because of something you did. But what you must understand is you are going through because of something you didn't do. Should have ran around right there. See, you were the person that said no, and somebody else said yes, and they got away with it. But because you said no, the devil made it look like you said yes. Y'all ain't ready. Y'all ain't ready for me. In other words, watch this. You are suffering because God knows you, and he knows what you're going to do and what you will not do. In other words, God is saying, I know my child is suffering this afternoon, but watch this. She ain't going to curse me. She may get mad at me, but she ain't going to leave me. She going to always trust me even when she can't trace me. In other words, you are in your storm simply because you said no to the devil. Y'all still don't know when to shout. I'm sweating hard. I'm working hard. I ain't going to work too much harder now. Watch this. So if you're in your storm simply because of nothing of your own doing, then why are you treating God like it's his fault? I got Bible to back it up. In this life, some rain must fall. Paul says, the sufferings shall not be compared to the glory that shall be revealed in us. In other words, if I suffer with him, then I'm going to reign with him. But here's the thing. Everybody want to reign, but don't nobody want to suffer. And God is saying it rains on the just and the unjust. Yes, watch this. Can I make an announcement to you? Yes, you can be filled. You can be saved. You can be doing everything right. You can lose your job. Your spouse can leave you. They can come pick up your car. But that does not mean that God is still not with you. Okay, watch this. Watch this. I got Bible to back up. Look how Job looked at his suffering. He said, now, watch this. He said, wait. He said, now, wait a minute. Now, you made me. He thought about benevolence and mercy, but in suffering, he said, I don't feel like you made me. I really don't feel like you love me, God, because this hurt. I'm going through this simply because, watch this, your name is on me. Y'all gonna catch that in a minute. Do you realize that the devil has a bull's eye on every believer's back? And his job, watch this, don't miss this, because his job is to prove to the naysayers that you're not who you say you are. But some of y'all falling in the trap. Because watch this, time hell break loose. You quit coming to Bible study. You quit coming to prayer meeting. You quit coming to Sunday school because you feel like when you come in the building, everybody know your stuff. The Sunday school teacher talked about your mind. You got to understand that your mind can mess you up because your mind can have you believing that everybody is against you. But I came to tell you, if God be for you, who can be against you?
So watch this. Let me hurry. So he has some inconsistent ideas about God. He said, now, you shine upon the counsel of the wicked. And Job saw wicked folk all around him, and they were strong in the hell in the body, and they had all kind of different spirits, and they were prospering in worldly affairs, and he who was in his deepest heart and sympathy with right and the God, and he was right with God, but he was reduced to the utmost distress. Can I tell you something? Listen, some of you, watch this. Some of you, the reason that you keep going through what you're going through is because you ain't got it yet. God is saying, I need you to depend on me. But see, this is what we do. When problems happen, we go get a bottle. Or we go get some puff ass. And I need to tell you, after you get through drinking, after you get through smoking, that problem is still going to be there. All that's going to do, if you smoke the weed, is going to mow you out and give you the munchies. And if you drink, it's going to make you go to sleep and wake up with a headache. But your problem still going to be there. Why not go down on your knees when you have... Can I tell y'all something? Oh my God. Can I tell y'all something? Listen, when you up at night and can't sleep, it ain't for you to be on Facebook. The folk that are in your mind and in your heart, that's the time that you need to go down on your knees and ask God to fix whatever is broke. And so here is Job. Job say, listen, there's some wicked folk around me. They're prospering. Listen, I left this morning. I got some neighbors. I got some neighbors. They don't go to nobody church. I see how they do. They out cutting grass this morning. Just as happy. Hey, brother, how are you? Pray for me on your way in. Whatever. And I'm saying, you need to be coming with me. Do you realize that we live in a nation that does not want God? Do you realize, watch this, we keep, like folks say, oh, they kept prayer out of school. My children pray every day. Because they ain't got to move their mouth to pray. Oh, my God. And watch this, as long as our children are in school, prayer is still in school. Because they know how to pray for themselves. I put it in for free, but watch this. Number two. Not only did he have inconsistent ideas about the maker, but watch this. He had unrighteous display of God's power. He says, thou knowest that I am not wicked. He said, Job said, wait a minute, now, God, you know who I am. You know I ain't that dude. I ain't that dude, God. I ain't wicked. I try to do everything that's right by you. Now, some of you get this mixed up when you look at the book of Job, because you got to understand the Bible says that Job was a perfect and upright man. That does not mean that Job was sinless. But what it means is that when it came to the things of God, Job had a track record that was impeccable. In other words, can I tell you this? Can I ask you this? What is your track record with God? Because see, keep on turning up. Keep turning up. Keep trying to show up at everything out there. And miss God, what he doing right here. Because watch this. I've seen folk get saved in the club. I've seen folk get filled with the Holy Ghost in the club. Because watch this. Either you're going to do it God's way voluntarily, or he will make you. Because watch this. The Bible says, watch this. Train up a child in the way he should go. And when he's old. You ain't old yet. And when he's old, he will not depart from it. In other words, watch this. Every time you go somewhere that you know you have no business going, you're going to keep on feeling uncomfortable. You're going to tell folk, don't put me on Facebook. Don't tag me in nothing. Because listen, I'm in my church. I'm working. And God is saying, that's your opportunity to bring your black self home. Job said, I ain't that dude. I do right by you. And I found out that you can do right by God. And folks still give you living hell. Because this is what they'll say. He ain't that good. No. She can sing, but you know, I know some stuff about her. Well, you know, she can teach, but I know some stuff. He can preach, but you know, you ain't know him when he was a teenager. Like your stuff squeaky clean. And some of you act like you Jesus' little sister and little brother.
that you don't do nothing. The devil is a liar. Christianity is a process. And can I make an announcement to you? You ain't got it all together, and you never will have it all together, because as long as we're in this flesh, we go have some issues.
And so, let me say this. I'm gonna put this in for free. Now, don't get this mixed up. You gotta have balance in your life. Watch this. I'm gonna put this in for free for the single folk and the married folk. This ain't even on my notes. I'm gonna get back to Job in a minute. But I do want to tell you this. You say your spouse got a position in the church. That don't mean you can't go nowhere. It simply means that when you come in the room, you become the thermostat. That's right. That's right. That when you walk in the room, because you are God's child, if they tripping and flipping, what happens is, because you're a thermostat, what you do, you turn down. If it need to be turned down, you turn it down. If it need to be turned up, you turn up. Watch this. In other words, watch this, and it does not mean that you ain't saved because you're there. I got scripture to back that up. Where did Jesus go? Jesus was at a wedding one night. Some of you are so sanctimonious. Some of these preachers, some of these apostles, some of these evangelists, you have the audacity to tell folk you ain't gonna marry them because they've been married before, when the Bible clearly says what God has joined together. Can I tell you something? Everybody God ain't joined together. That's why we got so many divorces. Some folk are so sanctimonious. Oh, you can't be around. No. You know, I was going to the family reunion. I was going to go to the wedding, but they're going to be drinking there. Honey, you just an ex-alcoholic last week. Now you done got so sanctimonious that you can't be around it. In other words, look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, become a thermostat. Don't let folk turn you up and turn you down. You be the thermostat. You change the temperature in the room. Watch this, I'm on my face, watch this. So he looked at God's power, and he found out that God was omniscient. God knew that he wasn't guilty. But his friends charged him. And now come on, Joe, come on. Come on, tell us the truth. It's just us. We your homeboys. We down like four flat tires. We done did a whole lot of stuff together. Come on, clean. You catching all this affliction, Joe? What you done? Your children dead? Your wife talking crazy? You can tell us. Doesn't that sound like some of y'all friends? Is it true? Inboxing, texting, is it true? Is it true? Doesn't that sound just like us? Why are you so concerned about other folk's lives when your stuff tore up? Job said, listen, I know you're omniscient. I know what I'm going through. Listen, I'm not guilty of. But he says, but is the righteous of afflictions? I mean, I'm righteous. I thought, watch this. I thought when I got saved and I got filled with the Holy Ghost and I began to speak in tongue and I began to tithe like I should, I thought that my problems would be over. I thought that when I was in the world, folk didn't like me. I didn't know the same mess was gonna happen in the church. I thought I had to watch my back with my folk outside of here, and I'm finding out that I gotta watch my back in the church. And we call ourselves God's people. I got 5 minutes. We call ourselves God's people, but we don't act like God's people. We act like his people out there. That's why I keep telling you there's going to be a lot of drug addicts. There's going to be a lot of winos. There's going to be a lot of homemongers and all kind of stuff, folk that ain't never been to church in heaven. You know why? Because they hard right. See, here's the thing about us. We front so much
Watch this. We pretend so much that we become what we pretend we are. And God is saying, watch this scripture. Those that worship me must worship me in spirit and in truth. In other words, the reason that some of you can't feel God is because you done duped yourself into thinking that you all right. Y'all ain't got to say amen. Watch this. Lastly, watch this. Job said, now wait. What's your divine organization? What should I expect out of this? I want to tell you in the 8th and 2 following verses. He ascribes, he seemed astonished that God, who thus produced and supported him thus far, would destroy his health and overwhelm him with misery. The same God that blessed him would allow disease to set up in his body. I'm going somewhere. The same God that you said sent that spouse, that same God would allow that person to walk out. That same God that gave you that job, that same God will allow that job to be snatched away from you. That ain't fair. God, what you doing? How you gonna bless me and then take something away? Oh, I got scripture to back that up. The Lord giveth. The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away. But then he said, blessed be the name of the Lord. What God is trying to get you to understand, that even though that thing that you thought was a blessing, God said, I can use your midnight to show you that I'm still the one that's going to take care of you. In other words, watch it. You may not have a job. You may not have a spouse. You may not have a whole lot of stuff. But God is saying, listen, you're going to keep living where you're living. You're going to keep driving what you're driving. You're going to keep looking how you're looking, because it's not them. It's me.
Let me close with this. But Job attempted to understand. He really did. He said, and these things thou hast hid in thy heart. If there's a reason, it is in thy heart. Shut up and hide from me, and I cannot reach. The more he thought about it, the more Job was embarrassed with the mysteries of his own being. In other words, what happened? Job went from blaming God to looking at what he had done. Notice I said, the Bible says Job was a perfect and upright man. Let's go back to last week. All them children he had, 7 sons and 3 daughters. The Bible said they parted 7 days a week. And instead of Job telling them don't do that, he simply pacified. Y'all got to watch this. Job knew what they were doing. They were partying 7 days a week at his different sons' houses and then inviting the girls over to party with him. Now, the Bible does not say what they were doing, but you done been to a party before. I can imagine what was going on. So Job quit blaming God, and then he quickly realized, wait, could I have avoided this affliction? My children dead now, but if I had one more chance, would me and my wife interrupt the party and just tell them we need to pray with them? I want to tell you, this hit me like a ton of bricks about 5 this morning. When you look at Job and you look at what the sacrifices that he made for his children, he did that for his children. But guess what? You can't get to God on the family plan. Job sacrificed. He repented for them. But watch the text. The text never said that they did it for themselves. I want to tell you, as we get ready to take communion and the door is open, I can see blessings in your life. And I can see God blessing you in a miraculous way. But if you don't believe it, it's not going to happen. In other words, the preacher can't do it for you. The Bible says, study to show thyself approved. A workman, not ashamed. Deacons, the problem with our church is not that we need more people. The problem with our church is that we're spiritually bankrupt. Because we don't understand the things of the Spirit. Yes, we shout. Yes, we feel good. But are we hearing the word of God? Because at the end of the day, when you get to heaven, when you get to the judgment seat of Christ, before you get to heaven, your life is going to be flashed before your very eyes. And the Lord is going to ask a question. Well, did you do this? You're going to say, some of you are going to say, no, I didn't do. Then the Lord is going to say, no. On August 2nd, 2015, at 1:26 p.m. at 1761 McFarland Boulevard, the preacher told you you couldn't get in on the family plan, that you had to get it on your own. Today, the door is open. Today, you got to make up your mind that you're going to quit coming to church and start coming to worship. This is serious business. This is serious business. People are dying every day. We still playing church. I don't know about you, but I know how to church. I want to worship. I move from just having church. I want to worship God. And what I like about worship, I ain't got to do it like you do it. I want to worship God in spirit and in truth. And can I tell you something? Just because folk hollering and screaming, that don't mean worship is taking place. Because light bills will make you scream when you ain't got the money. That's the truth. I want to scream now. But I want you to make sure your relationship is right with God. It ain't about me. It's about you. You got to know without a shadow of a doubt that your business is fixed. Look at Job. Job broke down. At first he was saying, it ain't nothing I did. But then Job said, wait a minute, let me rethink that thing. My children dead. Are they dead because I spoiled them? Y'all didn't know spoiling your children was a sin? You got to tell them no sometimes. When you have a child that has never been told no, they'll rob, steal, and keep. Let me tell you something. School, get ready to be back in. The door's open. You can come if the Lord is moving on your heart. School is getting ready to be back in. And I watch some folk. You know, you raise your children how you want to raise them. You do whatever you want to do. But they're going to have some problems when they're teenagers and you treat them like they're 25. Because in school, they're going to treat them their age and not how you sin. And so watch this. I don't want it to be said. If you ask JR, he'll say, man, hard on me. Yeah, I'm hard on him because he's a teenager. He's 14. He's going to the ninth grade. And so I'm trying to teach him that it does not matter what you have done prior. Your educational career starts this year. What you do from this point on will follow you the rest of your life. Watch this. Next week, I want you to bring every child. I want you to bring your nieces. I want you to bring your nephews. Me and the deacons are going to pray. We're going to lay hands on all of them. These educators that we have in our midst, they're going to help us with it. None of our children are going to be behind this year. None of them. We're going to get them the help that they need. All right? But it's going to take all of us working together. Listen. You want to know why you going through what you're going through? Why not you? Who made you so special that you don't have to go through that? Why not you? We all go through. I keep telling people, sometimes trouble comes to your house, knocks, say hey, and move on. But then sometimes trouble comes with a suitcase and say, hey, you got the spare room ready because I'm going to be here for a minute. But guess what? I found out that if I put Jesus in my business, he may not come when I want him, but he'll be right on time. Listen, you need this Jesus in your life. You are not exempt from afflictions. The door is open for you. You can come by Little Candidate Baptism by Christian Experience. As the choir sings today, the door is open for you today. We offer Christ to you. You come by Letter Candidate Baptism by Christian Experience. If you're afraid to walk, if you're here in school, this can be your church away from home. The door is open for you today. We offer Christ to you. God bless you. He will give you brand new life. He will give you brand new life. New life abundant. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. You ought to come. Come on, the door's open. God bless you. God bless you. Come on, we offer Christ to you. We offer Christ. We offer Christ. Oh, my sister. Come on, the door's open. He will give you brand new life. New life abundantly. Oh, come. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. You ought to come to Christ. Come on, one more time. The Spirit is still moving. The Spirit is still moving. Come on. You come by letter. Candidate baptism by Christian Experience. The door's open. We offer Christ. We offer Christ. Oh, my sister. Brand new life. New life abundantly. Oh, come back. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. You ought to come. thank God that the invitation has been extended. We have two candidates for baptism. Amen. Sister Ava Woods. Okay, all right, all right. I'm going to ask you some questions. I can't make you believe what you believe. But the Bible says you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart. You are saved. Do you believe that Jesus died? It's for her, for the baby. Oh, you want to get a bless? Oh, okay, okay, all right, all right, all right. We're going to bless the baby, all right? Amen to that, amen. All right, I'm glad we cleared that up. All right, so we have a baby blessing. And then we have candidate baptism, Alexis Pope. Come on, give God praise for... Amen, amen. All right, Alexis, do you believe that Jesus died and rose again? Do you believe that he has all power in his hand? How long are you willing to trust him? All right. The Bible says that you, Lex, this big Lex bumps you down, two Lexes. The Bible says that you are saved. We'll baptize you next Sunday. All right. So we'll get in touch with you and get you what you need. So Lex brought you down. Okay, good. All right, all right. That's good. Amen. Thank God for the... Come on, give Lord a hand clap praise for that. Y'all can return to your seats. Listen, I want to thank God. That reminded me, I want to thank God. I want to thank God as we get ready to partake in our communion. I don't know what y'all did Friday night, but whatever y'all did, our security guard said, listen, I got to get in church. I got to pay my tithes. We need to talk. Now, I do want to say this. It's amazing how God is moving. Amen? All right? And so we thank God for him. He does a wonderful job for us. But he just told me this morning, he said, listen, we got to talk because I got to get myself right. I got to get things right with God. So I thank God for all of you. Listen, as we get ready to partake in these parcels, the Bible says, examine yourself. If you have aught against your brother or your sister, you need to confess it at this time. Ask God to cleanse your heart, cleanse your mind as you get ready to take this bread and this wine, right? Father, we love you and we thank you and we praise you for this day and we just give your name glory. Thank you for this blood and this wine and this bread that was shed for us, the blood of Jesus. What can wash away our sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. We thank you. God, we ask that you forgive us for our sins and our transgressions. Make us worthy to be partakers. And we'll be careful to give your name glory and praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Listen from sin.
where he took me, singing glory. Singing glory.